Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the next video about how can we create an ebook-like layout using Wikitext with the custom markup plugin. Yeah? In the first video we did some default styling for indentation, and now we will have a closer look how we can replicate the definitions from here. Yeah? So as we can see, the first line has a caption, yeah? So we want to replicate this. I want to start with a class caption, which is only cup, which is not 100% right because I'm using only the first character and the layout is first word, but yeah, we can change this later. Then the next line should be text indent, which looks like this. Yeah? And now we could copy paste, but Ctrl V, the whole thing into the next line and so on and so on. Yeah, but this is boring, yeah, because it's a lot of work. So let's remove it and define a new snippet, which we can do here. Yeah. So we click this and then we say configuration, yeah, for the snippet configurations. And we add a new snippet, which is called text indent snippet. Yeah, okay. Then we need a caption. Oops. Ctrl V. And we need the snippet text. Yeah. It's important here that there is no white space, so this is the text, but it can be more text. Yeah. But if it's only one, then there should be no white space. Okay. Click it or save it. And now we have the possibility to use it from here. Yeah? So I can mark the whole paragraph, so all paragraphs, and then click this one. Yeah? Now it's indented, everything is done. Yeah? Click it again. So there is Ctrl 6, and then we can say 1. Yeah? This is the number 1, this is number 3, 4, and so on. Yeah? So if I click 1, then it's undone. Yeah? So this is a toggle button. Ctrl 6. 1, yeah, and now everything is like this. Yeah, okay, looks nice. What else is missing? We have Times New Roman here, so this is a serif like font, so we need a different font definition. So let's define a div with the class and say serif. Okay, looks good already. Save it. Okay, yeah, the point is, if we simulate a mobile phone, yeah, everything looks nice. This is okay, but on a PC the lines are a little bit too long. Yeah? So now let's have two columns. And that's it. Yeah? We have something which looks really nice. Yeah? And we didn't use any HTML, we used Wikitext. There is only one thing which is a little bit bad, so there is a lot of text, yeah? So it says text indent. Yeah? If someone reads this text, okay, they will know what should happen. Yeah? But maybe it's possible to make it shorter, and it is. With the custom markup, we have a new pragma which is called custom, and the name of this glyph here is angle. Yeah? This angle brackets is angle. And then we can say classes is text indent, including the dot. Yeah? And now, if we use this angle bracket, yeah, then it's automatically applying this class. Yeah? So we could remove this again, so text indent, and only give it 1. Yeah? So now it uses the same styling for everything. And that's the big advantage of the custom markup plugin. So there is a possibility to abstract a lot of settings away. Yeah? What it does automatically, the angle bracket automatically uses paragraphs. Yeah? So like this. Yeah? I could change this to say, okay, it should use element div. Yeah? In this case, it looks the same, yeah, because I defined a class WTC, yeah, which looks like a paragraph. Yeah? So that's why there is no big difference. But you can see it's a div now. Yeah? And that's the big advantage. Yeah? What else can be done? Yeah? I can say, okay, I want to have this a paragraph. This is the end. Yeah? Inspect. Yeah? Now it's a paragraph, but with no classes. Yeah? So I would need to define the class here again. Let's say text indent. Yeah? And now it's indented again. And so on. So there you can see the custom markup has some default configurations, but then almost every aspect of an HTML element can be tweaked again. Yeah? For example, I could say a side. Yeah? There is there is no styling at this at the moment. Yeah? The side. Maybe it looks different. Yeah, I will discuss this in a later video. But yeah, as you can see, there is a new custom element or custom pragma, which will be discussed in future videos again. But what did we do? We did define something that we imported from an ebook site with custom markup, and it looks very close to what we had in the book itself. Yeah, and in the next video we will have a closer look if we copy paste content from other sites to TiddlyWiki and see what happens. Okay, see you in the next video. See you soon. Have fun.